summer, all to myriad of families. Thank you so much for taking some time over the summer to tune into this, the special summer 2017 edition of ColeyCast, my monthly video message to the Alta Murrieta community. If this is your first time tuning in or you are new to Alta, welcome. I am Brent Coley, the principal. And basically, each month I put together a little video message like this and talk about the coming events, things to look forward to, exciting things happening at Alta. And in this broadcast, I want to take a few minutes and talk about getting ready for the new school year, specifically our orientation. So, first thing we want to do is we want to get our calendars out. We want to mark the date, Thursday, August 10th. Thursday, August 10th is orientation, aka that's the day you get to find out who your child's teacher is, okay? So Thursday, August 10th, we're gonna be in the new multipurpose room. We will be open from 10 a.m. to 2 p.m. and again from 5 to 7 p.m. It's open house style, so you can come anytime between 10 a.m. and 2 p.m. Then we're gonna close for a couple hours, take a break for dinner, and then we'll open up again from 5 to 7 p.m. for those people who are working during the day. And that's when you will come in and find out who your child's teacher will be. But there's some steps that you need to take place before that date. So save the date, Thursday, August 10th, but before that, we're gonna ask, we need all parents to go online and complete the online orientation process. If you have had a child in school for a while, you will remember that several years ago, they used to do everything. They would send home a whole bunch of forms on the first day of school, contact information, all of the district forms. You used to have to fill all that out by hand and bring it back. The district has put all of that online, and we need all parents to go ahead and complete that before August 10th. So here's how you do it. First of all, we've got a letter here, a two-sided letter. I have put this on our Facebook, our Twitter pages. It's also on our website. So all of the information I'm going to talk about right now, you can find in this letter right here. So the first thing that you need to do, step one, go to our website at altamurrieta.org. altamurrieta.org, and right on the homepage, you're going to see an announcement that says Aeries Parent Portal. That's the place where all of the online paperwork gets done. So go ahead and click on that. That will take you to another link that takes you to the Aeries Parent Portal. If you are a returning student from last year or you are newly enrolled, you can go ahead and do that. If you were here last year, you will log in with the same email address and password that you used last year. If you don't remember your password, there's a link that you can click and it'll send it to you. If you are new to Alta, you will create a new account, and it is going to ask you for a verification code that you can get from our school office. So go ahead and call our school office beginning July 31st. We reopen on the 31st, and if you need that code, just call the school office and they can get you that code. So once you are logged in, it's gonna take you through a few steps, basically asking you to verify your information from last year and review the required documents of the district. So for example, it's gonna ask you, is all of your contact information correct? Did you get a new phone number? If so, you'll have the opportunity to either confirm, yep, that's the right number, or I gotta change that number. If you need to review and add or remove any emergency contacts, maybe you need to add a new family member on the emergency contact list. That would be the person who is allowed to pick your child up after school. So go ahead and review that section. The next section is the medical history section. And it's very, very important. I'm gonna slow down for just a second here because I wanna emphasize, this is the section where you need to identify, does your child have any medical concerns that the school needs to be aware of? And there's a whole list. For example, does your child have asthma? If your child has asthma, the school needs to know about that. Maybe your child is allergic to bee stings or has a peanut allergy or something like that. If that is the case, you'll want to review that list of medical concerns and check the box next to any and all medical concerns. Again, I want to emphasize the importance of this. It's crucial that the school has accurate medical information for your child, because in the event of an emergency, we're going to want to make sure that we are able to assist that child appropriately. So please don't rush through that. Really look and make sure that you have identified any and all. And if there's no medical concerns, that's great. There is a box that says, I'm going to make sure I get the wording right. The top box, it'll say no known health problems. So if your child doesn't have any known health problems, you're going to want to make sure to check that box. But again, please be sure that you are really taking time to review that and accurately complete that section. The next section is all of the required district forms and documents that you are asked to review by yourself and with your child. The district's promotion and retention standards, the media release forms, those types of things. So the district's internet acceptable use policy, those types of things. There are links that you can click on. You can either print them out or read them right on the computer. And then next to it, you'll see a little checkbox that basically says, I have reviewed this document. So it's like a digital signature. So you will review each document and check the box saying that you reviewed it. And once you submit it and you're all done, that's it. No forms sent home. It's all done online. So once again, we're asking all of our families to go online, altamurrieta.org, click on the Aeries Parent Portal link, log into the Aeries Parent Portal, and complete all of that required information. We're asking that everyone finish that, get that done if you would, by the end of the day on August 8th. Then the easy part comes. That's the hard part, and really, it's not hard. We just did it for my kiddos a couple of days ago, and it takes less than 5 minutes per child. In terms of clicking everything, reviewing the documents takes a little bit of time, but it's really a pain-free process. So once you have done that, now comes the fun part. August 10th, as I said, between 10 and 2 and then 5 and 7, anytime between that time, you're going to want to show up to the multi-purpose room, having already done the online portion. When you have already done that, basically you're going to show up, and if you were here last year, it's going to be just like it was last year. We will kind of have a little route to follow. You will come in and we will just confirm. We'll take your name and say, did you complete the parent portal? And you say, yep. We'll look at the list and say, yep, you're all done. We'll direct you to the next station, and they will tell you who your child's teacher will be. Very quick, very easy. So we're really encouraging everyone, you need to have the parent portal information done beforehand. Now, if you don't have computer access at home, you could go to the library. We will have some computers set up in the multi-purpose room that day, so you will be able to do it at school that day. However, I'm just letting you know, depending on what time you get here, there may be a delay. You may have to wait for a computer. So if you can do it at home, have it done early, because really parents have said, wow, this was fast and easy. If you have the parent portal done before you get to school, you'll be done in potentially 5 minutes. So once again, August 10th is the day. 10 to 2 and 5 to 7, have the parent portal information done beforehand. If you can't do it beforehand, we will have computers on hand that you'll be able to do it there. And then we will get you your class placement information, but we cannot release that information until all of the required documentation has been done in the Aeries Parent Portal. Once again, information about all of this is available on our website at altamurrieta.org. You will see we've got the little letter here. This is also on our Facebook and Twitter pages and Instagram. If you haven't followed us yet, be sure to follow us on Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter. We put constant updates there about what's going on. So if you have any questions, as I said, please feel free to contact the school office. We reopen on the 31st. And if we don't see you before then, we hope to see you in the new MPR on August 10th for our orientation day. Thank you once again. I'm so excited for this coming school year. Have a great rest of your summer, because it's not over yet, depending on what time you watch this. It's not over yet. Have a great rest of your summer. We'll see you on August 10th. Looking forward to a great school year. Have a good one.